video, I will show you how to paint your cold porcelain and especially which products you can use to paint it. So, first of all, you can paint with pens, permanent pens. I have here two colors, the black and the green. Also, you can use acrylic paint. And also you can use pastels. This is powders, okay? So also in powders, if you want, for example, to paint a brown color, you can use the cacao powder. And also you can use edible colors, okay? So I will start, first of all, painting. As you see, the result of my cold porcelain is not really white. So I need some to keep it in white. White, 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 very white. So I will paint this part and then I will compare so you can see the difference between the real white and the when I paint it, okay? I am using this product, which is from Wilton. And I will paint it. Also, you can use acrylic white paint. This is sticky, use a little bit of shortening or vegetable fat in your hands. Completely painted. So now you will see the difference between this one and the original. I also have to tell you that I have done this recipe like 2 minutes ago, and you can immediately start working with the porcelain. You don't need to wait 1 hour, 1 night, 1 day, nothing. Okay? So this is our white, and this is the original. It's clear the difference. Okay? So this I will keep it in a plastic bag, seal it. This is the white. And now I will make some yellow using this powder. Open a little bit. As I told you, you can use also the pastels. This is edible powders, so I have this a lot of, that's why I am using this also for this project. See that the advantage of this product is that it's very easy to paint, to model. If you need more dark, you can add more. But let me tell you that when the porcelain dries, the color is more strong. Okay, that's all. Let's make a hole. And this is our yellow. And now let's make our brown using edible liquid, okay? Edible color liquid. I will paint a little bit more because I am making a doll, so I need for the hair a good amount of brown. I told you also to use cacao powder, so I will divide this. Okay, and then I will see what is the best. So I will use liquid and also cacao powder. Which is this one? Let's start first with this. Let's see the difference between this one and the cacao. Okay, so this is the brown that I got from the edible color. Okay, I will keep it this side. And now I will use the cacao powder to this piece. One teaspoon, and let's see which tone we get. The same I use sometimes when I want to color the fondant, which is edible. Cacao powder to get it brown or to get extra dark black. The first thing is to paint your fondant or your sugar paste with the cacao and then add the color black. Because if you add directly and only the black color, the edible black color, the result is not completely black. It's like gray, but not black. This is more lighter, a lighter brown, but it's not bad. You can add more to get more darkener. Okay, now I will show you the different tones from these two colors. So this is using the edible color and this is using the cacao powder. Okay, I will put this in a bag. I have 2 tones of brown. And now I will clean my hands. I will use this color to make the color of the eyes. So green, I need a little bit, not too much. And just go and paint it. Okay. So, and now just mix it. Easy and practical material is the porcelain, cold porcelain. Okay, and this is the result of this. Also, I will put it in a bag. Finally, we will try this black with acrylic painting. Okay. And I will show you the difference between this and the edible black color, okay? I have already painted using edible gel color, so you see the difference. This is kind of messy. The color that I get is not completely black. That is a big difference. I got a gray color. Yeah, this is gray. It's not black. But I will show you now the black that I got using edible color. I will show you which brand I use also. But also I want to have different tones of black, so I will keep it this like it is. Okay. This is with acrylic paint. This acrylic paint, I got this. I will place in a bag. Now I will show you the black that I got yesterday. I did yesterday. I will wash my hands first. This is the black painted with sugar flake black extra. I didn't use cocoa powder before directly. I used this on this and I got this. And you see the difference is really very notorious with the acrylic painting like this, like with this. Okay, So this is just for your references. And now the last color, this is the other white that I have, the other white, some blue. And now I will paint them more blue. I have still a little bit of cold porcelain. I will use pink because I need pink color. So this will be in pink. The brand of this is what is the brand of this? Wilton. Okay, this is from Wilton. Yes, this is gel. Not too much. Okay, now let's paint it. And always try to keep it a little bit of white. I will paint more pink. In case you need more, you can paint small quantities, small amounts of any color. Okay. If you paint everything in one color, specifically one color, then the problem is that then you have to remake again the cold porcelain. See how intense is the food colorings. I really use a little bit. I have added already more white cold porcelain, but still I have a nice pink tone. Very beautiful. Okay, and this is the last one. So I have here all my colors. You see here. Okay, this is all the colors that I got. And also yesterday I painted this, which is ivory color, also edible color. And that's all. Thanks for watching, friends. See you in the next video. Bye!